Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises. And today's video will be Book of Judges, Chapter 3. Let's get started now. This chapter continues the story of the Israelites after the death of Joshua and the period of the Judges. Judges chapter 3 focuses on the cycle of sin and repentance that the Israelites go through and how God raises up Judges to deliver them. The chapter begins with a list of the nations that the Israelites failed to drive out of the Promised Land. These nations include the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. God allowed these nations to remain in the land to test the Israelites and see if they would follow His commands. However, the Israelites did not obey God's commands and began to intermarry with the people of these nations. They also began to worship their gods, which angered God and led to His judgment. God allowed the Israelites to be oppressed by King Cushan-Rishathaim of Aram-Naharaim for 8 years. When the Israelites cried out to God for help, God raised Othiel, the nephew of Caleb, as their deliverer. Othiel defeated King Cushan-Rishathaim and delivered the Israelites from their oppression. The land had rested for 40 years under Othiel's leadership. After Othiel's death, the Israelites once again fell into sin and began to worship the gods of the Canaanites. This led to God's judgment once again, and he allowed them to be oppressed by Eglon, the king of Moab, for again years. When the Israelites cried out to God for help, God raised Jabed, a left-handed man from the tribe of Benjamin, as their deliverer. Eug devised a clever plan to assassinate King Eglon, which he executed successfully. Eug then led the Israelites in a victorious battle against the Moabites, and the land had rested for 8 years. After Eug's death, the Israelites once again fell into sin and began to worship the gods of the Canaanites. This led to God's judgment once again, and he allowed them to be oppressed by Jabin, the king of Canaan, for 20 years. When the Israelites cried out to God for help, God raised up Deborah, a prophetess and judge, as their deliverer. Deborah worked with Barak, the commander of the Israelite army, to defeat Jabin's army and deliver the Israelites from their oppression. The land had rested for 40 years under Deborah's leadership. Judges chapter 3 teaches us several important lessons. First, it shows us the consequences of disobedience. The Israelites failure to drive out the nations from the Promised Land led to their intermarriage and worship of other gods, which resulted in God's judgment and their oppression. Second, it teaches us the importance of repentance. When the Israelites cried out to God for help, he raised up Judges to deliver them. Similarly, when we realize that we have sinned, we must turn to God in repentance and ask for His forgiveness. Third, Judges chapter 3 demonstrates God's faithfulness in delivering His people. Despite their sin and disobedience, God raised Othiel, Eld, and Deborah to deliver the Israelites from their oppressors. In the same way, God can use us, despite our flaws and weaknesses, to accomplish His purposes. In conclusion, Judges chapter 3 continues the story of the Israelites after the period of the Judges began. It shows us the consequences of disobedience, the importance of repentance, and God's faithfulness in delivering His people. We can learn from the Israelites' mistakes and strive to obey God's commands, seek forgiveness when we fail, and trust in God's faithfulness to deliver us from oppression. The cycle of sin and repentance in Judges chapter 3 serves as a reminder that we need a Savior, and that our ultimate deliverance comes from God through His Son Jesus Christ. Por favor, compartilhe conosco seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer, ansioso para vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!